स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू।
एक्सरसाइज नंबर 11। मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू माय ऑनरेबल कलीग फॉर हैविंग मेड ए वेरी एनलाइटेंड स्पीच ऑन द बिल एंड द वेरियस इश्यूज इन्वॉल्व्ड। There was a considerable discussion on the merits and demerits of the legislature. I must thank various honorable members for the very learned and profound discussion which they have had here in this house today. While thanking them for that, I must say, since that question was not an issue before the House, I will not waste the valuable time of the Honorable House by replying to that. In the statement of objects and reasons of the bill, it has been stated that equal representation is the main object of federalism, or something to that effect. While agreeing that is one of the purposes or one of the objectives, I cannot agree that is the sole objective or the purpose. Considerable discussion has taken place amongst the constitutional pundits. Essays have been written, books have been written about this question. While conceding to what my honorable friend has said that it is one of the purposes, the modern trend seems to be, as one of the constitutional writers has said, that it is not the equality of the states that is the main purpose, but what it calls it is the essence of statehood that is the main purpose. What is meant by that statement is that in view of the diversity in a state, the various interests in a state, the various sections of the people which constitute a state, it is the representation of sum total of the essence of statehood that is represented in the upper house. I think there is much to be said on that. Sir, I was going through the discussion that took place in the Constituent Assembly. Nobody referred to this aspect of the matter because it seems there was a consensus that the second aspect of the problem as discussed by constitutional writers, it is the essence of statehood, namely representation of the various interests, diverse people, diverse culture and other aspects, which is the purpose of the representation in the upper house. As a result, except one honorable member, nobody mentioned even the question of equal representation of states. The main emphasis was on whether there was necessity for a legislature And on these lines, we have had an excellent treatment of the subject in the house. Thank you.